Hello, High Levelers. In this video, what I'm going to do is cover how the GoHighlevel platform can handle your courses, course creation, and even the selling or even giving away of your courses, and how you can do all of that inside the GoHighlevel platform. So this is going to be great if you have, like, maybe you have a course that you give away for free as a lead magnet. Maybe you're a coach or consultant, and maybe you have courses that you want to sell. All of that stuff can be done here inside the GoHighlevel platform. And I want to sit back and create a real quick video to kind of show you how this happens, how it works, and just a system inside of the Highlevel platform. Let's hop into it and take a look. Alrighty, so here we are inside of the GoHighlevel platform. This is one of my demo accounts. And on the left-hand side menu here, I've gone down to membership. So right now the memberships area here is where you want to sit back and be in order to create all of your courses. Now, right now you see this gives you just like a little dashboard, how many opt-ins you've had in the last 30 days. By the way, again, this is a demo account. So this is just, I'm just using this on the last 30 days and how many sales you've had. So it is pretty nice. So you can sit back and don't have to sit back and look at anything else. You can just come right in here to memberships and see how many people want to opt in for your particular courses and just take a quick look. It's a really great dashboard. Now, here under the courses section, there's a couple things that you need to set up here. First of all, membership, just to give you a little bit of history here, memberships used to be something that was alone and by itself that you can access independently to access courses. Now, here over the past year to year and a half, Highlevel has released what they call the communities area, or more or less their communities portal. Now, their communities portal is what sort of brought several features in Highlevel together. So course creation, they came up with communities, and then even the affiliate training. If you do affiliates and you have affiliates sign up to sell your products, you can actually have all of those communications, and they even recently included billing and support. So people can even look at the billing and how much you're charging them if you're charging them a monthly reoccurring for a product or something like that. So the communities area is what is now being used to access all of the coursework. Now, communities is a whole other big one. As a matter of fact, you can look, I'll have a link in the description to my communities one. I just created one here not too long ago that gave an update for 2024 that goes over basically how to go through and create it and all the things regarding communities. So I'm going to kind of skip some of the basic setup and let you go watch that video. And I really want to focus just on how to create the courses inside of this particular video here and how you get that set up and some of the basic components there. But just keep in mind, communities, you do have some community settings here. And if you go inside settings, this domain area is where you actually have to set up the link that people can go to get. So if you take a look here, I already have this set up. So if we come over here and go to our portal, notice here we do have some branding. It just logged us directly in here because we already had this, but I'm going to just log out for real quick. Notice that this is the login page. All the stuff over to the right is completely brandable. You can change or customize any of that. People can log in with Google or their username and password. Keep in mind, when they log in for this, an account inside of the contacts area to access this particular portal. So here we're going to go ahead and just sign back in. And right now, you notice that we come to the home page. But if we go over here and take a look, we can join a group, take a course, and so forth. So if we go into the take a course, or you can click on these little three buttons here and go to courses, you can pop in and go directly to the courses that we have. So this is what the online courses look like inside of the GoHighlevel platform. I'm kind of showing you this, and then we're going to work our way backwards. So notice in each one of these, and this right here is already pre-built for you here, but you can customize the image and the name and things like that. So if we click on the particular course, we do get their own particular course page. I have not really customized this. This is sort of out of the box standard, but this header can be changed. The button color, all the stuff that you see in here can be changed. Notice we have 0 out of 13 lessons. The instructor information has not been filled out of here, but all of that stuff can be populated and filled out. You can have different instructors for different classes. You can have links and information about them in the bio, things like that. Then we'll take a look at where you configure those. But notice each lesson can have its own image, so you can customize each lesson for that particular thing, and then you can have another image for the class itself, and it can have its own. So this is basically how it is. This right here is one category, the introduction. Then we have another category that we have lessons under. And I'm going to explain what this are. I'm just trying to let you know what you're going to visually see and then how the back end looks when we go create that. But this is another category, and the things in here. So that's what these major things are here. These are the categories, and then these are the lessons inside of here. Now, if you click on the lesson, you do get an area where you see a video. You get to post one video. Unfortunately, that's a limitation right now. One video for the training for this that you get, and then you get an area to put in text, links, things like that. There is over here in this area a file area. So if you want to have downloads or lessons or labs or manuals, PDFs, things like that, you can also have links over here that will have for downloads if you actually have them. So you can do a bunch of cool things that way as well. So right now I'm just going to go back here, and now that we've taken a look at this, let's go back into the Highlevel platform and see how we get this configured. But this right here is where you would go configure the URL for this and get all of that stuff set up. So now we're going to pop back into memberships. Now, if we take a look at courses here, there's two things that I'm going to really focus on here, and that's products and offers. Now, everything that you build inside for a course or something like that, you should build with the smallest footprint possible. Meaning, if you have five different courses, then create five different products for each one of those courses. Okay, unless for some reason that particular course you want to combine sections, because right now each particular product, again, when you configure it, has to be added to an offer before it can be made visible or even be seen in either a funnel that you're selling or even on the membership page. That is how the Highlevel system pushes or displays the products that you have. So right now everything begins with the products. So we're going to go inside here. This is where you would just configure your products. Again, with Highlevel, there are unlimited number of products, unlimited number of courses, unlimited number of websites, unlimited number of funnels. There's no limit on the things that you do inside of Highlevel. There's no limit to even media storage. If you want to have videos uploaded and hosted inside of Highlevel, you can have as many as you want. There's no storage limits as of right now. There's just a storage limit size per file, and I believe that's 5 gigabytes. So every file that you upload, video, PDF, whatever, has to be less than 5 gigs because that is a file size limit. So right now, one of the things I want to explain to you is once you create all your products, you do have the ability to come up here and for the library sorting, which means you can sort of move and shift like how these are going to be displayed when people log in. If you want to rearrange the order of them to see which ones are on top and which ones are bottom, you do have complete control of that here. For the manage comments, this is where, if you wanted to, you can just manage any of the comments that are made. Now, comments are something that you can turn on or off inside of each particular product. So right now, I'm going to go ahead and hop on board to this Highlevel onboarding training. Now, inside of here, this is kind of the things that we get. This is the basic interface. So we see this onboarding course. This is a category. So we can add a lesson. We can add a subcategory or even an assessment. You know, if you want to do like little tests and things like that, you can even have those inside of here as well. But right now, the product structure here, you can create a category. And right now, one of them is onboarding course. And that's the only category we have. And then we have all of these, which are lessons below them. So right now, this is how you would create a lesson. If you'd wanted to, you can just create here, click add lesson, give it a name. Once you have it, it will just show up at the bottom. You then open it up, and inside here, this is where you can upload a video file, an audio file, give it a title, onboarding, add any descriptions that you want. This is where you can give it just an image, that little image that we saw beside the lesson. This right here could be the picture that gets shown. Now, up here for post visibility, everything starts in draft mode. And once it's in draft mode, it cannot be seen. Now, this is nice because you can actually start working on lessons and building lessons before they actually become published. So you can work on them here, get everything looking right. And then when they're right and you want to release them to the to the people who have purchased it or something like that, you just publish it. And once it's published, then now people can see it, view it, and interact with it. And then here's the area below where I showed. I'm sorry, I'm kind of blocking. But this area down here where you can attach files. So this right here, you can just attach as many files as you want to for that. So this right here is the basic structure for just creating a lesson. Again, if you've ever used a course or lesson builder, this is very similar, very intuitive on how you would end up doing this. Now, if you wanted to, notice for these lessons, I can move the lessons around. They're not fixed. So if I did create this one right here and I want to move it up to the top, I can simply move it all the way up to the top and it's done. Now, up here at the top, here's where some of the other configuration options are. If you go to details, this is where the course description and the thumbnail or the image for that particular product gets coming into play. So this is where you configure it. If you go into your customizations, this is where you can add your instructor's name. You can put the photo of your instructor, name, title, bio, all that kind of stuff up for this. So if you want to have just some other images here, and you can even come down here and add some JavaScript and things like that, and even some header codes if you really want to get specific and drill down into to do like Google Analytics to see how many people are actually logging in this particular product. You could do something like that as well. Here, customization, these are sort of different themes that Highlevel gives you to actually view. Personally, I just been using this one to preview, but again, if you take a preview of this one, it just kind of shows you what the course is like on here. So I'm going to go ahead and close this and just kind of give you an example. If I want to look at the preview of this theme, then this theme makes it look a little bit different. Notice that this right here for onboarding courses, they're displayed differently. The status bar is up here. So it just looks a little bit different. But you can choose this theme if you want to apply it to this product or even this one right here. These are the only ones that they have currently. Then they may come up with more, but this is all that they have. But it basically just gives you a different look over the lesson and how it gets displayed. So you have full control over it. And once you go into it, you would need to customize this to go into changing the header and the font and the colors and things like that. If you're interested in this, again, check out the membership video on my site. It goes deeply into how to do this and configure everything inside the membership area. I'm just trying to help you understand some of the basic components of the products. And then we're going to get into offers and then how that kind of gets displayed. So here, if we take a look at offers, this says, give me a list of all the offers that this product is a member of, okay? So right now you can have one product, and again, you can lump that product into multiple different offers. That's the great thing about creating the product. You create the product at the very base single course. Then you can add mix and match. Like you might have an offer that gives you course 1 and 3, then another offer that gives you course 2 and 5. So you can change and mix any of these offers up. You can offer them for free. You can sell them. You can do whatever it is that you want. So, but this right here just kind of shows you what the offers are in. We did take a look at comments earlier. Now notice over here, you can turn this on or off. So this is up to you if you want to get interactions with your people taking your courses. Sometimes this can be distracting, especially with monitoring all of these. If people give you a negative comment, it does happen. But here, if you click on hidden, you can enable it. And now you're enabling this for all of the onboarding course. And you therefore, people are allowed at the end of the lesson to put a comment in there. And then other people who have access to that product will now be able to see the comments and that particular lesson and things like that. So, but that is available for you as well. And then certificates, if you want to have certificates over when somebody finishes a particular course or product, or maybe they finish all of the lessons, that you might give them a certificate or something like that for finishing, that's an option as well, but I'm not going to go over and cover that in this particular video. So right now, that's kind of the breakdown of how you would create this, but let me go ahead and quickly just show you the create it. Now, keep in mind, here's one of the nice things about this. Start from scratch or import from Kajabi. So right now, if you are a course creator and you're currently using Kajabi and you're tired of them charging you all this nickel and dime stuff for this, by the way, when you get this particular course, you can have the lowest starter plan at $97 a month with Highlevel offers everything I'm talking about here. You can have a business, you can sell your courses, you can do everything completely unlimited for $97 a month. As cheap as that, if you wanted to. So this is much cheaper than trying to go to Kajabi and paying those fees. But if you want to, you can import your classes from Kajabi in here and have it created automatically. But right now, I'm just going to choose start from scratch. So here, notice that there are a couple of different courses. This is one of those things I really don't understand kind of why they do this, because you can build them with any of this stuff. I just kind of do build your own. That's kind of where I start at. And you would just give your product a name, lack of creativity, offer one. Here's where we get to choose all of our products. So let's just say I want to do the affiliate course, the landlord starter kit, and then this section 8. All three of these products now are going to be put into a new offer that I'm going to sell and things like that. And this offer doesn't always necessarily have to be visible to the public either. You know, it could be a special, like I can put this offer, you know, inside my communities area where people you know, may have very specific access to and only members of my community can see it, like a special offer I'm giving just to them and not making it public to everybody else. So right now I might say, okay, I'm just going to one-time fee, let's do $6.97 for all this. So right now I'm not going to put the payment in test mode. I'm just going to click create. Now that right there is as much as you need in order to create an offer. Okay. So right now, once the offer is now available for you to publicize and even sell to the public using a website funnel and things like that. So real briefly here, again, I know this is how easy and quick you can get products set up, you can get offers, and then once you build out your funnel, these offers are included in a drop-down list and very easy to add to a one-step order form. So guys, I really hope you this answered some questions regarding could I build out courses, what features or options are available, things like that. I really hope I answered a lot of questions. I am a Go High Level affiliate. So right now, if you haven't signed up for Go High Level and you're looking to get signed up, use my link below for signing up. You get a free 30-day trial to get this. You can build out all of your products, get everything moved over, start testing it, start getting money all through the Go High Level platform before you even have to start paying for it. Hey, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please hook a brother up, subscribe to my channel. I always appreciate your support. And if you've gotten either a couple pieces of information, a few nuggets of information, hit on the like button, leave me a comment. I appreciate that because YouTube really shoots these videos up and gives my channel a little bit more status and so forth when people interact with my videos. Guys, thanks so much for hanging in with me and have a great day. Bye-bye.